Okay, so what we're going to look at here is Kirchhoff's current law. And Kirchhoff's current law basically says that all of the currents that are going into a node have to come out of it. So if you're looking at a circuit with certain unknowns, you can use Kirchhoff's current law to figure out what the missing current should be. So for example, we can start by examining any particular node that we want. So the basics of what we're going to do is the sum of the currents in needs to equal the sum of the currents out. So for node one over here, for number one, the sum of the currents going in, going into here, we have IY. So we have IY. And incoming from over here, this one is negative one. So even though it's negative, that's okay. We're just going to write it as negative one, just like it tells us to. So that's everything that's going in, and then that needs to equal everything that's coming out. So for here, the one that's coming out is I sub x. And we can't really do much with that right now except to just write it a little bit prettier. I sub y minus 1 equals I sub x. So we're kind of stuck there, so no problem. Let's keep on investigating. So let's look at number two, this one right here. So number two. The sum of the current in needs to equal the sum of the current going out. So let's see what's going into this node. We've got this guy. He's going in. So we have going on the in. Now, even though it's a negative two, that's okay. We just write it as negative because it's on the inside. In needs to equal out. We just write it exactly as it's written. Okay, now if we look over here, this one's going into this node. This IX is going in. And what's coming out is this. This one is coming out. So that's IZ. IZ is coming out. So we have minus 2 plus IX is equal to IB. All right. Again, we can't really do much with that right now. So we'll keep on looking. We'll look at number 3 over here. So number 3. We know that everything going in needs to equal everything coming out. So let's see what's going in here. Just this guy. This 3 amps is coming in to node 3. So we write 3. That needs to equal everything coming out. So what's coming out? From here, we kind of look and we see, okay, this IY is coming out. And the other thing that's coming out is this minus 2A. So we add plus, because we're adding all the things that are coming out, the current itself just happens to be negative. We don't let that bother us. We just kind of turn our brains off for a second and write down exactly what the formula tells us to. So we've got 3 equals IY minus 2. So we want to solve for this IY. So I'll add 2 to both sides, and I'll get IY is equal to 5. So that's nice. IY is equal to 5. And the units on that is going to be amps. So IY over here is now 5 amps going this direction. We just keep the arrows going the same direction as they were when we initially started the problem. So let's see what we can do with that information. We can use it over here. Here we needed IY, so instead of IY, we'll write 5, and then we have minus 1 equals IX, so that means IX is equal to 4. And so that's going to be our solution for IX. So for IX right here, what we want is 4 amps, and it's still going this way. We don't change the direction of the arrows. So now we have that one, and as a matter of fact, we can actually use that over here on our number 2 node. So we've got minus 2 plus, and for IX, we put in 4 equal to I sub z. So I sub z is equal to 2. So that's that answer. So this thing right here can be 2 amps, and it's still going in that same direction. Now, what we can do is an error check. As we can see for node 4 and make sure all the numbers come out right. Okay? So let's look at node 4. I have a ton of space to work with, but for number 4, everything going in needs to equal everything going out. So what's going into 4? This one. this guy. This guy's coming into 4. Just 2 amps is coming into 4. So that needs to equal everything coming out, which is this guy is coming out at 3, and this guy is coming out at negative, there we go, plus a negative 1. So we check it out. Is 2 equal to 3 minus 1? Yep. So that means we did it right, and now you can successfully execute Kirchhoff's current law.